Hello, welcome to Chronic Mechatronic! Just in case anyone's ever going to watch my videos, that is. Well, anyway, it looks like the tip of my soldering iron's come to the end of its life, so I'm going to make a set of new ones showing you how I do it along the way. Since these long-lasting, specially plated replacement tips aren't exactly cheap and don't last very long either, apart from being basically a chunk of copper anyway, I had a look in my local hardware store and, as it turns out, the biggest single core wire they sell has actually the same diameter. So I got a few feet of it, and now let's make some replacement tips. I'm going to start off with the bevel tip as it's the easiest one. Basically, it's just a piece of diagonally cut off wire. I've never actually used one of these, but I figure they could be useful, so I'm gonna give them a shot. And I'm making all of the tips quite a bit longer than needed, because the pure copper actually dissolves quite rapidly into the solder. Conical tips would be easiest if you had a metal lathe, but I don't have one, and putting it into the chuck of a drill press and filing it round works just as well. The straight chisel being one of the more complicated ones, you need to flatten the end of the wire before shaping it with a file. Though I just realized, theoretically, if you want to make a very narrow tip, you wouldn't need to flatten it down with a hammer at all, you could just file it down on both sides. And now let's go on to the main reason I'm making this video. Anyone can shove a bloody piece of wire into a soldering iron, but no one can properly desolder surface-mounted components using a bloody piece of wire. To desolder surface-mounted components without destroying them, you generally need a pair of these SMD soldering tweezers. Even though there are very cheap ones out there, they are not an option if you want to be really chintzy. Luckily, we can just make our own soldering tip to fulfill that task. I'm taking another, a little shorter piece of wire because these bits won't see nearly as much usage, and I'm splitting the end with the hacksaw. Bending it apart with a screwdriver. Filing it down on both sides. Now I can hammer it into its final curved shape. Since the end's gone even more V-shaped, I'm pulling and crushing it around a nail clamped into the vise to actually make it straight in the first place. And now filing the cutout to its final width, the idea being to make it just a tiny little bit wider than the length of the components we want to desolder. In my case, the components are 3mm long, so I'm making it about 3.1. The last step is to shape the outside to kind of make both prongs similar in size and thickness. And very importantly, we need to bevel the lower corners because solder much rather tends to stick to surfaces than it does to corners. Try them out.
We'll be right back.
that's about it for this video. If you haven't clicked away yet, please tell me what you think of it in the comment section down below. If you liked it, click that subscribe button because it is actually really difficult to make videos without even having an audience. Thanks for watching, you'll see me next time.